Good morning, children. This is the fourth session of English for class 8. Now today we are going to do the questions and answers of which lesson? Yes, how the camel got his hump. So let's begin. Here's the first question. What tasks do you think were assigned to the dog and the ox? I repeat the question. What tasks do you think were assigned to the dog and the ox? Let's have a look at the answer. So here's the answer. The dog was assigned the task of fetching and carrying things. Of fetching is to bring. To fetch means to bring. Of fetching and carrying things. That was the task assigned to the dog. The ox was given the task of plowing fields. So what was the task given to the ox? Plowing fields. Once again, I repeat the answer. The dog was assigned the task of fetching and carrying things. The ox was given the task of plowing fields. Next question. Why did the camel live in the middle of the desert? Why did the camel live in the middle of the desert? Let's have a look at the answer. Here's the answer. Camel lived in the middle of the desert because he did not want to work. You remember the story? The camel was lazy. The camel was idle. He did not want to do any work. Let's move on to the next question. The next question. What made the dog, the horse and the ox very angry? What made the dog, the horse and the ox very angry? Let's have a look at the answer. The dog, the horse and the ox were very angry because man asked them to work more in order to compensate for the camel who did not work. So they were told to, they were asked to do work, more work. Why? Because the camel did not do any work and they had to compensate for that. Now let's move on to the next question. Here's the next question. How did the gym know the horse was complaining against the camel? How did he know? Let's have a look at the answer. Here's the answer. The jinn was the master of all the deserts. He knew about all desert animals. He knew about all desert animals. When the horse spoke of long legs, the jinn advanced. He understood what? The jinn knew he was talking of the camel. Why? Because he was the master of the desert. He knew what was happening in the desert. Now let's move on to the next question. Here's the next question. The camel was looking at its own reflection in the pond. What does it suggest to you about the camel? What does this suggest? Let's have a look at the answer. It suggests that the camel loved his own image and is conceited. He is very proud of his image. Next. The camel said hum repeatedly. How did it affect him? Let's have a look at the answer. How did it affect him? The hum ultimately became his hum. The jinn punished him by placing hump on his back. So, what happened to the camel? He developed a hump on his back, which was a punishment given to him by the jinn. Why? Because he did not do any work. He was idle. He was lazy. Now, let's move on to the next question. What, according to the jinn, was the use of the hump? What was the use of the hump? Let's have a look at the answer. According to the jinn, the hump had a purpose. What was it? It would store energy for 3 days and would enable you to work for 3 days without eating. So what was the purpose of that cup? It would help him store energy so that he would work for 3 days continuously, that too without eating. Next question. He has never yet learned to behave. In the light of this, what is the writer's opinion about the cat? Let's have a look at the answer. According to the writer, the camel is still a lazy animal who is unwilling to work. So, camel is not willing to do any work. It seems that the camel did not behave himself and lived lazily in the desert. It is probably for this reason that he continues to carry the hump and live in the desert. It's called the sheep of the desert. Still has a hump on his back. But we come to the end of this. Golu was a curious baby elephant. He used to ask strange questions to all the animals he met. Do you ask questions to know more about the things in and around you? Have you ever imagined what would happen if you stop asking questions? Golu was very inquisitive by nature, and that inquisitiveness varies from child to child. It is very good to be inquisitive. Especially children must be inquisitive because that helps them to learn more about the things in and around them. The eagerness to know adds to one's existing knowledge, and that will help you to move ahead in life. So always be eager to know about the things in and around you, to learn more, to add to your knowledge. What did you do over the weekend? Were you generally active or idle? Idle like the camel. Please check your bag before starting to discuss or answer the question. Check your bag. Do you have a hump on your back? Yes. If you are lazy, surely you will develop a hump on your back. Like the camel in the story, how the camel got his hump. You remember the story? Why did the camel get a hump on his back? Actually, it was a punishment given to him by the jinn. Why was that punishment given to him? For being idle, for being lazy, for not doing any work. So children, never be idle, always be active. Now, were you active or were you idle during the weekend, over the weekend? You were active. What did you do? You indulged in different types of games and sports activities. What did you do? Okay, so you have read newspapers, magazines, storybooks, and of course, you must have watched television, your favorite channel. Okay, that's fine, but don't forget to listen to English news. Why I'm saying so? That will help you to increase your knowledge. That will help you to improve upon your English, your vocabulary. So that's how you spend your weekend. Very good. But never be idle. Yes, of course, one tends to take rest, one is relaxed over the weekend. All that is okay, but don't be idle. Idle like the camel. If you are idle and lazy, nobody will like you. Remember, the animals in the desert, they did not like the camel. Why? Because he did not do any
ball. So always be active. I'm sure you were active over the weekend. Did you try new sport? Did you go to the mall? Yes. I know all of you love going to the mall. Enjoy shopping, eating variety of food items there. I'm sure you did not sit idle. You watch TV all day now? No, no. That's not good for your eyes at all. You watch television, but not all day long. It's harmful for your eyes. Remember that. So, don't be idle. Be very, very active. Keep reading, learning, add to your knowledge. With that, we come to the end of this session.